Western Turbo in Portland, Oregon, installing a Sentinel system on a Clark, Michigan loader equipped with a Detroit diesel engine, equipped with the master control, the coolant loss valve, and above is the system is also installed with the new STV Sentinel test valve. The red-handled valve can be turned to test the Sentinel system for operation at any time. Two Freightliner government vehicles, numbers 915 and 916. The order was for 2,500 trucks, and these Class 8 haul trucks were equipped with the Racor 460 filter separator. Is mounted in place of the standard AC primary filter on these Detroit 60 series 400 horsepower engines. This angle, you can see the bottom of the diaphragm primer pump mounted in the head to allow for easy priming at filter change intervals or if a loss of diesel is experienced. This is the GMC Top Kick midsize truck. There's also an identical version of it, same body style, under the Chevrolet name plate of Kodiak. These trucks are equipped with Caterpillar 3116 diesel engines. All those versions have a fuel filter water separator by Racor. This is the model on these Top Kick trucks. It's the model B32002. On the driver's side, under this step, Racor 75-1000MAV, you'll note it has all four ball valves mounted in the front for convenience. This is the way all the 75MAVs are built now, and also the triple manifold is available this way. This is on a tug operation of a sand and gravel company, Ross Island, in the Portland, Oregon area. This purifies the fuel for this. Diesel marine engine. That dredge, and here's where they have their waste oil stored, and inside this housing is where they've got the Racor blender. International highway truck equipped with the Racor 6400 Nautilus separator. 400 has a coolant heater in the top and a spin-on filter with a see-through bowl and drain on the bottom. Medium-duty trucks equipped standard with Racor separators. These trucks are built in Louisville, this conventional style. This is a model number L or F800, and next to it here is an F700 model. And the Racor is mounted on the passenger side. Front of the fuel tank, it's a model 225 Racor with a see-through bowl and a drain valve. Our style Ford is also equipped with the Racor separator. Newer model, 1991 and a half, and it's equipped with the 460 separator, which has the diaphragm primer pump built into the head and a see-through bowl with a drain. This is the only filter on this truck for the fuel system. See your version 1990 or older version of the Ford cab over. And this has the model 225 on it. The same as the conventional we saw earlier. This particular lettering on it indicates this truck was built in Brazil. It has the ear lamp labeling, but it's still a 225 and takes the replacement R26. This is a Thomas West Coaster model bus equipped with a Detroit diesel engine.
Originally it came with this filter, primary filter, mounted behind this electrical compartment. I just removed that and we put the 1000 Racor on this bracket that I manufactured, and it's just real tap bolt to the stock that mounts this. And I just took their lines, since it was the same size JIC as we use, disconnected their lines, brought them down and hooked it onto the Racor, and then hooked the heater up in the electrical compartment here to a key hot wire. That's it.
Kosher's warehouse in Milwaukee, Oregon, near Portland. This is one of their forklifts using a hydraulic filter with the water-removing media in it. But they have the spin-on water-removing filter on the return line going back to the hydraulic reservoir. And they have the gauge to indicate service. This is Fleming Foods in Portland, Oregon. Only 60 over-the-road tractors here. The box there on the card is the Cummins blender, the remnants of it. It didn't work, so they hung the Racor OF3 blender right in front of it. Everything's been working out great. Their truck's with a heater water separator, Conmet brand, and they've removed those since and put the Racor Turbine Series 1000 FGs on. Looks based in Lewiston, Idaho. They use the lifeguard anti-spill device on the vent line. This Duckworth aluminum fishing boat, they've got the fill and the vent coming out the back to protect that finish on the boat and to keep the fuel out of the water. The lifeguard is positioned inside that. There you can see the bottom half of the lifeguard. It just comes right out of the tank, that line going up to vent the fuel tank. Is the lifeguard trap, which prevents the fuel from going overboard. Even when this boat is trailered and stored, it'll prevent thermal expansion. Bluebird school bus, and it's equipped with the Racor 225 on the driver's side, about a fourth of the way back on the frame. This is the best shot I can get with the bottom part of the 225. You can see the bowl and the bottom part of the element. Connector coming off the bowl is the 12-volt thermostatic controlled heater. Through the fence is as close as I can get. But there is the 1000 FG mounted next to an air dryer. And it's got the 24-volt heater in it. You can see the T-handle on the top. I bet you can see the... Well, the fuel blender, it takes the diesel crankcase oil from the loop system that's already used and blends it back with diesel fuel and cleans it up. This one's located at the National Guard in Clackamas, Oregon. It's the National Guard at Clackamas, Oregon. Here's another Racor item that they put to good use. It's a hydraulic recycling system that cleans up when they're doing maintenance on the trucks or when they have a failure, gets the contamination out of the reservoir and allows them to separate on a Mack truck mounted right up on the firewall. And then just below the base of it is the heater, coolant heater. And this particular one, they have a factory installed automatic drain, which uses air pressure to automatically expel the water contamination. This is a Volvo white GMC. It's got a cat engine, and then it's got a Racor separator. It's a B32001 mounted on a Cummins head as a primary separator on this cat engine. Guard fuel dispensing product, a competitive product for our interceptor fuel dispensing. At the log show, and it's got a frame mounted 1000 FG with a heater in it. And then next to it there is a CR Brakemaster after cooler type air dryer.
This is a 6.9.
It has a 25 series Brake 4 on it. One
world of a job.
The Detroit Diesel dealer, and he installs a lot of the Sentinel kits, so he's got that installed, or the installation display here at the logging show. Boat. They use for moving logs around, and it's got a Detroit Diesel engine in it. It's built by Beaver Enterprises in Oregon, and he's just hooking up a Sentinel system on this. They generally all have the Sentinel systems on them to protect the engines.
Well, right now it's going
down. This is a shot of the smaller pond boat that he builds, and this is a larger version next to it.
Racor I use as a primary. The secondary filter is right here. But this is a 1972 one ton that's been custom built. V653 twin turbo. And about 300,000 miles on it now, and I only use it part time, vacation. Once in a while I'll take a special load back east or something, and just gotta have a good time, and kind of a plaything in a way, but it hauls about, I got a low boy bed for it that I hauled half of what the big tree hauled, about 25,000 pound payload, max.
Corporation. Ross Corporation is located in Eugene, Oregon, and they manufacture a specialized logging equipment, and they utilize the Racor turbine series on most of the diesel engines. There's a Racor turbine 1000, that's what they use on most of this equipment. People have known Racor to be a supplier of heavy-duty fuel filter water separators with heater options available for cold weather. Racor 1000 turbine series has been added to heavy-duty trucks and off-highway equipment to provide primary filtration and water separation, and sometimes additionally fuel heaters. Improvements have been made to the turbine series in recent years, including improvements in the bowl material, the drain material, and the feed through for the heater now comes through the black plug in the side of the base. It's also available in 30 micron replacement elements featuring aqua block for cold weather applications. We would like to discuss the 400 series spin-on fuel water separators from Racor. As diesel engines have advanced with new electronic controls, Racor has kept pace with this new fuel filter water separator, the 400 series. It's available in a variety of sizes. The 490 is 90 gallons an hour. The 460 model is 60 gallons an hour. Heavy duty on-highway truck applications, we're going to focus our attention on the 490 model, which offers more appropriate sizing for today's more aerodynamic trucks and allows for engine mounting features. Racor 490 for heavy duty truck applications features a easy service spin-on replacement element. This spin-on element is available in 30, 10, and 2 micron for a customized application, all featuring the AquaBlock filter media, which removes all the contaminants, including water, from your fuel. It offers a see-through bowl to check visually and remove contaminants and water through the drain located at the bottom of the filter collection bowl. Has encased a diaphragm priming pump to allow for easy priming with clean fuel to the system. Come in handy when replacing the service element, draining the bowl, or when a loss of prime to the engine is experienced. I'll show you now is how easy the 490 series from Racor is adaptable to one of today's more popular electronically controlled engines, the Series 60 Detroit on highway engine. The engine is a 450 horsepower .7-liter engine. Detroit comes standard with an engine mounted primary filter and an engine mounted secondary final filter.
Detroit Diesel's most current on highway truck engine. We're going to be installing this Racor filter on it, removing the AC filter installing this one. Basically, this engine is primary use is on highway truck, anywhere from 285 to 450 horsepower. This particular engine happens to be rated at 450. It is a fully electronic controlled engine, overhead cam, six cylinder, four stroke engine, which is a little bit different for Detroit Diesel, but it has taken us from less than 3% of the truck market to approximately about 26% of the truck market today. And that began in about 1987 when this truck engine went into production. Okay, so right now I'm just going to go ahead and just demonstrate how simple it is to replace the AC filter with the Racor assembly, which this filter is the R90P or the 490 series Racor filter water separator. It also has a priming pump built into the system, which allows it easier for the drivers to pump fuel into the system in the event that they run their truck out of fuel. So basically all you have to do is just disconnect your fuel lines from primary fuel filter at the tank to here and then from here to the fuel pump. So we'll just go ahead and disconnect this fuel line here. This line runs directly to the pump. And if there was another line on it here, it would be at this point here going to the fuel tank. So you just have to remove this fitting and the fuel line from that point. And then we need to take off the fitting you're basically doing is replacing the filter with the filter, and you're using the same fittings and lines over again. It is a 3/8 pipe fitting that goes in from this point, and that just simply threads into there. And we need to remove the filter from the engine. That's a simple set step with just a couple of bolts that hold the filter to the engine. Okay, now there is a spacer block that needs to be installed at this point, and all that does is bring the filter a little bit further away from the engine to allow easy access to the removal of the filter itself. Okay, now we need to put the new filter on. In some applications you may require a little bit longer bolt to make this filter fold up to the engine. Again, you're using that spacer block to pull the filter away from the engine just to make it a little bit easier to install the Racor filter. Alright, now after the filter is installed, bolts are tight, you just need to simply put the fuel line on at that location.
Very lucky, line 2, very line 2, please.
Okay, now you'd also want to put the other fitting in at this point and the line that goes back to your, or comes from your fuel tank. At this point, since we do have the fuel priming pump on the filter head itself, it allows us to easily just prime this system up and get it ready and back on the road again. The simple process of priming the system, all you basically need, if the driver happens to end up down on the road and runs himself out of fuel, he's able to get somebody to put some fuel in his tank. All he really needs is a coin, and he just has to crack loose a vent here on the side. He doesn't need to take that plug all the way out, just needs to crack it loose, and then just simply start pushing on the pump. And then that will draw the fuel from the tank through the filter and up into our priming pump, and then into the rest of the system and prime it. Okay, now earlier, Racor, on their first design of this system, had a bypass valve on it. And what they've done now on the 490 series is incorporated that bypass in there. Originally, the driver had to hold this valve in here and then do the priming, and what that allowed is the fuel to come directly from the tank and go right to the fuel pump. And now, with this type of system, it just comes in from the pump and bypasses itself. And that's basically the installation process, and you can probably figure, depending on the application, no more than 30 minutes to do this job. You may want to have a little drip pan underneath to collect some of the fuel that may spill out.
This is the Freightliner business class mid-series truck with the series 50 Detroit diesel engine installed, and this is the fuel filter water separator located on the frame. It's the model Racor 690 with the availability of a heater and water sensor or without a heater and water sensor. And here we've chosen the inlet port to be this left front side and the outlet port to be the rear top side. And it's mounted on a nearly 90 degree L-type bracket coming off the frame. Comes from the tank to that inlet port through the Racor separator and then out to a engine mounted Detroit AC secondary filter. The model 690 uses the R90P 30 micron element and the same bowl as the 490. It has a 200 watt thermostatic controlled heater, and we've designed a weather pack connector to have one end ground and the other end hooked to another weather pack connector to hook into the wiring harness, the same as the 325 Racor, which is used on the business class when a Cummins or Mercedes engine is installed in this truck. This one, as you can see, also uses the water sensor, which connects to a light amplifier and then illuminates inside the cab when the water fills up to about an inch and a half in the bowl, and alerts the operator to drain it. Separate shot of the bowl heater. It's a cow rod type coil heater, 200 watts with an internal thermostat, which is important for the electronic controls to assure that the temperature of the fuel is not above the recommended operating temperature of the fuel for the electronic controls.
They figured that the chair was there for that reason. But the chair.
This is JC Manufacturing. They use the lifeguard LG50 to keep the fuel from going out the vent. It's the LG100 for capacity. Manufacturing again, and here they have their two tanks, filling ports and two tanks vents. Right inside you can see the LG100. There's the lifeguard sticker telling you how to proceed with filling your boat now. There's the lifeguard right there. These are the Prince Craft model boats. They build aluminum fishing boats and pontoon boats also, and they use the LG50 as standard equipment. They're built in Quebec. Fueling area, there's the fill port and the vent fitting right there. And this is the lifeguard, the cow, telling them instructions for filling a portion of the LG50 on the Prince Craft. gives you an idea of the positioning of the LG50 and also the relative ease of installing it in the aftermarket to field retrofit boats without the lifeguard. PCM marine engines. That's the 320 Racor OEM with the metal painted bold private label PCM. It's a 320 Racor OEM, uses the S3227 element. Colt Parker logo included for identification of manufacturer. It's the Robalo and Maxi group. The Robalo line of offshore fishing boats, part of the Brunswick group, U.S. Marine. This is the Fillport, and it's got the lifeguard sticker telling you how to fill the boat to prevent fuel from going out the vent using the lifeguard. And this is the vent fitting right here. It has a shroud to keep moisture out from going in to the vent fitting. This week in the Wall Street Journal had a special inside the cover placement in the Chicago edition. As your craft marine at the IMTEC show, their marine engines come standard with the rack 320 Rack 02, the Chicago Skyline. Here's Suzuki Marine outboard engines. And they market the 320 Rack 01, the see-through bowl version, with a private label. There's the Racor unit. See-through bowl uses a Racor element S3227. That's a private label for Suzuki or Parker logo for identification of the manufacturer. Correct Craft high performance ski boats use the PCM Pleasure Craft marine engines, which come standard with the rack filter, the 320 Rack 02. Dean Atik, or PCM on their engine side, was using a Fram unit. This is one of the earlier boats, and you can see the orange and black Fram filter, which now will be a 320 Rack 02 filter. All outboards, and this is a competitive filter they mount in the outboard, but the 320 Rack 01 with the see-through bowl could mount right here. It would meet with the approval of the Coast Guard to mount in this position on an outboard boat. And this is typically where you see a lot of the competitive aquapower SMI Merc type filter heads. Flies the ski Brindella boats, so they'll have the 320s on them as standard also. They'll use the S3228UL unit that comes with the Fram. And that'll now become the 320 Rack 02.